I'm going to make some luffa soap today. I have my handy 3-inch PVC pipe mold stuffed full of wonderful luffa fiber. I use a test cap plug. There are better end caps if you can look and find them. This is what they have at the store, so I use a little bit of masking tape just to tape it on there, seal it up good. And I have a block of melt and pour soap, which I am cutting into small pieces. I'm going to put in this Pyrex container and microwave it till it's melted, and then pour it in the soap mold to the top. I have the soap melted. I stirred and microwaved till it was all melted, and now I'm ready to pour it into my mold. Before I do that, I'm going to put a little bit of alcohol in it. Alcohol helps the soap stick to whatever you put in it, which in this case is luffa. So just enough to where I think it'll soak down through it a little ways. Try to get most of it. And then I'm going to pour my soap in. Try to distribute it around evenly. And be careful not to overfill. I'm going to try to cover the luffa. There will be a few bubbles rise to the surface. But usually add just a little bit extra, make sure it's covered well. Then that just has to sit. In a few days, that'll be well hardened and firm enough to where I can get it out of the molds. And this is what I end up with. Logs of luffa soap. These need to be sliced, and that is the hardest part. Normally, to get my logs out of the molds, I have to take them and pound them on some concrete to knock them loose. The longer they sit in the molds, the easier they'll come out. And there's other tricks for getting them out. You can get them real cold, and you can actually put a little vegetable oil inside your molds before you pour them. But I don't like to do that. It leaves the logs slimy. So I guess I need to show the next step, cutting these logs. This is how I slice my luffa logs. I use a miter box, the same 10-inch wide, I think it's called a taping knife. It's like a giant putty knife. And I just pound it through. Well, actually I push it into the log. And if it's too hard to push all the way through to get through the luffa fibers, I use my handy rubber mallet to pound it the rest of the way through. Now, they're easier to cut if they sat around for a while and they've gotten a little harder. If they're still a little sticky inside, they are really difficult to cut. They don't come out very even. And it's easy to make mistakes. I put a few little marks here so I know how far to cut. And my goal is to make bars that are about 4 ounces or slightly over. Then once you get your bars cut, you use this shrink wrap. It's like a little shrink wrap envelope or something. And tape it on there. Then use a hair dryer, heat it up. And it'll shrink the plastic on it. Seals them in pretty good. And then your final step would be to put a label on it, so people know what it is and where to get more. And that's how I make luffa soap.